So we are discussing new methods to find system of linear equation or solve system of linear equation. I have taken one sample problem so that I can illustrate that whole method. And the first method we'll be discussing is called as a Gauss elimination method. So we basically want to follow certain steps, and by using those steps we can find out. It's very easy, but let me just write down steps anyways. See, the first step here is write system of equation as Ax is equal to b. Okay, write it in the matrix form. Then next is reduce A to upper triangular matrix by row operations. Then rewrite equations, and then get x, y, z values. Okay, so let's just see how we can solve it. It's fairly simple. So we are going to follow these steps one by one. Okay, first, how do we write it as Ax plus b? If I want to write this as Ax is equal to b, A is the coefficient matrix. So I'll write down all the coefficients. This is 1, 3 and minus 2. Then 2, 1, minus 3, and 3, 2, minus 1. Then this is x. X is basically variable matrix, and b is the constant matrix on the right side, 5, 1, 6. So first step I did was I wrote it in Ax is equal to b form. Once I write it as Ax is equal to b form, I have to reduce this A. A is over here. I have to reduce A to upper triangular matrix. Now, what is an upper triangular matrix? Upper triangular matrix is when you have all the values below the diagonal are 0. So let me write that down. When you say upper triangular matrix, it simply means that all the values below the diagonal should be 0. And then that is an upper triangular matrix, right? So we'll reduce this to upper triangular matrix. And please remember that we're basically trying to find an echelon form. So it's only row operations, no column operations are allowed. Okay, so I'll write down here, reduce A to upper triangular matrix. Okay, I already wrote this, by only row operations, no column operations allowed. Fair enough. Let's simplify this. So if I have to reduce it to the upper triangular matrix, I want to make these three things zero. First, I'll focus and try to make these two zeros. How do I do that? To make these two zeros, I'll write this as R2 minus 2 times R1. I'll double it and subtract. And R3 minus 3 times R1. So it will give me these two zeros. So now after this operations, I'm surely going to get these two zeros. This 1, 3, minus 2 will remain as it is. This 5 will also remain as it is. But now these two rows will change. Okay, let's really quickly do that. If I want to do R2 minus 2 R1, you know my method, right? I multiply R1 by minus 2 and then I'll add to R2. That becomes much easier. So let's follow that. Multiply R1, the row 1, by minus 2 and add it to R2. So multiply by minus 2, the answer is minus 2. Add it here, becomes 0. Multiply by minus 2 here, this becomes minus 6. Add it here, that's minus 5. Okay, then, okay, you do that with me, okay? If I multiply by minus 2, this is 4. 4 and minus 3 is going to be 1. Well, multiply by minus 2 is going to be minus 10. And 1 is going to be minus 9. Let's do that here. The second operation is going to be for R3. Okay, I'll multiply R1 by minus 3 and add to R3. Multiply by minus 3, that's minus 3. Add here, becomes 0. That's perfect. Well, multiply by minus 3, minus 9. Add here, minus 7. Multiply by minus 3, that's 6. And minus 1 is 5. Is that correct? Minus 3 into minus 2 is going to be 6. 6 and minus 1 is going to be 5. That's correct. Well, multiply by minus 3, that's minus 15. And 6 is going to be minus 15 and 6 is going to be 9, right? Minus 9. Okay. So once you find like that, all I want to do is I just want to make this 0. Okay. My focus is just to convert this matrix into upper triangular matrix. That way, if I have to make this 0, well, I will do R3 minus R2. Well, I'll divide R2 by 5. What if I divide R2 by 5? What if I divide by R2 by 5 and 7? Is that correct? Well, if I apply R2 by minus 7 by 5, 5 will cancel out and you get minus 7. If I do this operation, I will get this as, well, 1, 3, minus 2 remains as it is, 0, minus 5, 1, x, right hand side, 5, minus 9, all stays as it is. This will stay 0 because this is 0. And if I apply this operation, this will become 0. That was the aim of this operation anyways. And then if I apply that here, it's going to be minus 7 by 5 plus 5. Do the math and it's going to be, I think, 18. And here also, I'll get 18. Okay. So, well, I found this matrix and this is clearly an upper triangular matrix. Now, at this point, as soon as you get an upper triangular matrix, you rewrite the equation. So, let me do that. If I rewrite equations, okay, I'll write down these equations in the form. Okay, this capital X was actually X, Y, Z. Okay, to rewrite equations, just multiply row by column. So, I'm going to get this as X plus 3Y minus 2Z is equal to 5. Okay, and then second equation is going to be this row by this column. It's going to be minus 5y plus z is equal to minus 9. And then this is 18z is going to be 18. Now, from this equation, I can clearly see z is equal to 1. Now, you put z equal to 1 over here. And from here, you'll get y is equal to 2. And put z and y over here, you'll get x is equal to 1. And then finally write down answer as x, y, z is equal to 1, 2, 1. Very simple method, okay? And this probably you've seen it in the lower standard as well. And the name of the method is Gauss Elimination Method. Okay, let's just go through the steps once again. First, you will do is write this as ax is equal to b form. Then reduce matrix A over here, okay, to upper triangular matrix. And while you do that, only do the row operations, no column operations allowed, okay? This form is called as echelon form, right? And rewrite the equations. Once you get this in the form, rewrite the equations and write down the final answer of x, y, z. Very simple. The first method of solving system of linear equation, okay? These are all linear equations and this whole thing is called as a system of linear equation. And this is the method to solve, okay?